Well, these days, we are all looking out for better alternatives to that crappy share it that used to exist with its ton of ads and bloatware. Well, say no more. We now have our own airdrop-like sharing for Android. And that is the new nearby share feature for Android devices. And you can use it on older devices too. So in this video, let's have an in-depth look at it. And if this is really the best alternative to share files in Android devices. And before we start, this is your host Manik. Welcome to the channel. And if you wish to stay notified about the latest videos, do click on that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it. To start with, this nearby sharing is great, as you don't have to install any app on your device. Just install the latest Google Play services and you will be good to go. In fact, it will come as a standard option in Android 11, plus it is available on most Android devices, old or new. And as you can see, I am testing it with my Galaxy A6 Edge Plus and OnePlus 6. So a way old device and a latest one. Now to get it on your devices, just enroll in the Play Services beta program by scrolling to the bottom of the page on its Play Store listing, or just download the APK and install it manually. And the links to both of them will be in the description area. So once you've updated to the latest version, simply choose the file you wish to share and click on Nearby Sharing in the share sheet. Now just wait while it searches for the devices that are nearby. And it hardly takes a couple of seconds. So yes, it is fast. Just tap on that device and see the magic. Click on accept and it will initiate a secure connection. And the real magic starts here. So there are three modes to transfer a file. Wi-Fi only, data only and offline. So as the name suggests, Wi-Fi only will transfer to the devices on same Wi-Fi network. Mobile data mode is to be used whenever you wish to transfer a small file. And a Wi-Fi connection is not easily available. And the third one, it simply works in offline mode without eating up even the tiniest portion of data and would probably be the fastest, you might think. So I tried all of these methods and I transferred the OBB file of PUBG, which is around 2 GB in size. And the results were something like this. So in the offline mode, it took around 4 minutes to transfer the file. In the Wi-Fi mode, it took around 8 minutes and 30 seconds. Because it is dependent on Wi-Fi for uploads. So yeah, use offline mode for best results. Plus even if you choose mobile data as default for bigger files, it will automatically switch over to Wi-Fi to get the best possible speed. So it might not be the fastest out there, but things will surely improve in future. And I see it as one of the most handy features in Android right now, because of the convenience it offers and the space it saves on your device. And overall, a big thumbs up for this feature. So that's it for now. Do like this video if it helps you out and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one.